Hello and welcome to Web of Light. I'm Dr. Kevin, and today I have as a guest host, Elmer J. Howard. Hey, Elmer, welcome.
Thank you.
Elmer and I have a long history together. We've written movies together and shot videos and traveled.
Yep.
So what are you doing these days?
I'm building my business, my financial management services company, building that up so I can step away and do filmmaking full time.
Good, good. So here's somebody who's living the dream and balancing practical and passion.
Yep.
You know, I think we can all take a lesson that you can have both practicality and passion in the same sentence. A lot of times people think it's
one or the other.
Yeah, what's one or the other? So no Angie this week. Angie is actually coming back from Logan Airport, where she has our two Irish lasses who have flown in from Dublin to be part of the Web of Light Expo this weekend. Here, Earth Day weekend, April 22nd, 23rd. The Courtyard Marriott in Nashua, New Hampshire. With that being said, we're going to pretty quickly move on to our guest who have also done a bit of a travel and come with us to come up to be part of the Web of Light Expo. And you may notice there's a couple of little different things on the set than normal. And so speaking of things that are other than normal, I'd like to introduce Jacqui Neulinger and Vaughn. And so starting with that, we have a set like you've never seen it. I know Angie is very sad that she couldn't do it, so she'll be over your booth this weekend.
Wonderful.
Checking it out. And we're actually, Elmer and I are gonna take turns experiencing this live as they're talking about it, and you're gonna see what you could possibly, coming to the expo this weekend, experience mm-hmm. yourself. And then we're going to have one day of full sessions with you on Monday at the Wolf Healing Center as well.
Correct.
And I know you have a couple of different things you do, but what I want to start with right here is we're going to put Elmer pretty quickly in the chair because he's going to be there for about 20 minutes.
Correct.
And while he's in there, we're going to talk about him.
I figured this much.
So I'm going to let you, Vaughn, are going to start telling him what to experience here. And then, Jacqui, you're going to set him up.
Okay.
It will be a benefit. We don't know what the interaction will be. There's never anything negative that's been reported in how many years, Jacqui?
Well, 6 years that I've been working with the technology and more than a dozen that it's been out here. So, yeah, quite incredible.
But whether that'll be on a physical level or psychological or spiritual substance is not to be known until you come back out of the Stargate Astrum.
Okay.
What we do know is that there's a cleansing effect on the blood. There's an increased coherence of the human biofield. So if we actually look at your energetic field, it becomes much more solid rather than having little holes or discrepancies in it. And there's an energetic alignment of the energy systems of the body, of the chakra, whenever you work with these technologies. And what you'll see here, we've got the Stargate Astrum, which is this beautiful grid on the floor, two-dimensional form of a three-dimensional Merkaba. And we have the Evo, energetic evolution. These are actually two different systems. They work together beautifully, and that each can be used on its own as well. So
kind of like Martin and Lewis, you can either watch a Dean Martin or a Jerry Lewis movie, or you can watch a Martin and Lewis movie.
Absolutely.
There we go. I'm just trying to put it in, you know, touchability here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So are you ready to see those look like what a maracas, is it? Yeah, those look like. Are you ready to grab the maracas?
Yeah.
Let's get this set up.
So while they're getting Elmer up, I'm going to be once we get him set up here, he's going to be on for about 20 minutes, and at that point I'm going to get to really talk with Jacqui and Vaughn Moore about what's going on and what's happening. And again, they're going to be offering this at the Web of Light Expo this weekend and at the Wolf Healing Center on Monday. Okay. And I see that the Evo is already changing some colors and doing something. Now, are those wands that he's holding, is that copper?
They are copper and stainless steel. And they resonate in harmony, you could say, with the Evo Energetica, the disc.
Okay. So now, what I want you guys to talk about. So first of all, I mean, this is all going to be underneath you anyways, because I have the best production staff in the world. So they will put your emails in your stuff. Well, I'll be underneath you. So as we're talking, it will flash up and people know how to get in contact with you. But the name of your company is?
Dominus Cervix International, and our website is dcienergetica.com.
Yep. Again, we'll have that in the bit. Okay. So Dominus?
Dominus Cervix is the name that was given. This technology comes through an extraordinary gentleman from the Netherlands. His name is John Hahn. And he's the person who received the information to create this technology and has had the courage to show up and actually be in creation over an extended period of time. Dominus Cervix was the name that was given with the tools. When we went to register in the United States, my attorneys told me that it was the only time that they'd ever been asked for a definition of what that actually meant. but what it, the meaning of the term is original opening or original portal.
Okay.
And that's the name that was given to John. John had an experience in the Netherlands some time ago. He was in the woods. He said that he saw a blue light. It approached him. He said it took a somewhat feminine form and moved quickly through his body, and that he was filled with the knowing of love. He said, you love your wife, you love your children, this is not the same thing. And cell phone didn't work, car didn't work, went home, told his wife, told her that he was crazy and that they would never speak of it again, and prayed that it would stop. But the information started coming. Reams and reams of information, and he was given very specific instructions on how to create these tools and to bring them through. And he's done an extraordinary job. John is a man of deep integrity. Everything is done exactly as requested, and the tools are quite spectacular. So this technology, the Stargate, was the original session-based system, and what we have is two-dimensional form of a three-dimensional Merkaba. So you have an energetic light vehicle.
Okay, so I'm going to stop you there for a moment, because I know that, we have people all over the country watching this, actually all over the world, and some are going to have different levels of understanding. Mm-hmm. So you're using a word that I think some people may be like, a Merkaba, So before we go too much further, you want to give us a definition of that.
Sure. A Merkaba is a geometric form. It is a pyramid shape that would be three-dimensional. In this case, it would be a three-sided pyramid with the point facing up, and then you'd have a secondary pyramid, three-sided pyramid with the point facing down. And the two would overlap. Mm-hmm. And in motion, you have one turning clockwise, the other turning counterclockwise. Counter-rotational flow. In many of the ancient texts and understandings, this was described as a light vehicle for the being, for the soul. For the part of us that might not be physical, to be able to move and increase awareness, increase experience.
So this is a representation of those two twirling pyramids.
Correct. And to my surprise, often I'll set up at an expo and somebody will walk by. Often we get someone who comes around a corner and says, oh my God, I dreamt of this. I was told to come here and here it is. Or, you know, and again they'll explain that this is what they're seeing energetically. It's not physically what I see, but I'm aware energetically in other ways that this is what's happening, and it's often what's reported to us. So kind of
that's
that way.
True. People have said that they have felt a field, a very strong energetic field, in the parking lot of whatever expo we are at, and they go on a search to find the energy signature that corresponds to it.
They come in and they find it. So we have this basic form, and then you'll see that there are 24 large crystal orbs. Each of those orbs is sitting on a disk, and that disk is hundreds of layers of sacred channel geometry, codes, and information. The orbs come in this form as part of the system. They also come as small orbs you can keep in your space, in your home, in your workplace, and ones that you can wear. And they're handmade for us in the Czech Republic. It's quartz that's been crushed, cleansed, and reformed. And then it goes into a device called a trainer. And the trainer connects these tools with the flow of energy. So when they first come in from Europe, they're lovely objects. They look pretty, but they don't have any energetic effect. Once they've been in the trainer for 17 hours and they come up, there's a measurable effect. And we will be doing demonstrations of that at the expo.
Okay, so tell me a little bit more about when you say you put it in the trainer. What's mm-hmm. the trainer?
The trainer is the magic, without a doubt. It's technology that John was given information to make in a very, very specific and clear way. There are two trainers on the planet. There's one that's with John in the Netherlands, and there's one that's with me in Pennsylvania. And that is the proprietary technology that the tools go into. And it is a very specific process. It's 17 hours in the trainer. And what I would say is that you've got these beautiful crystal orbs. The energy is not held inside the orb, but they are connected to a flow of energy. Okay? So John describes it as an intelligent energy. And to my surprise, every now and then I get an upgrade to the trainer. He gets more information. There's a change made. I've had the experience of getting an upgrade to a trainer, putting a new batch of orbs in, and getting a phone call from somebody across the planet who says, Jacqui, I picked up my orb that I got from you 4 years ago this morning, and it feels different. It's happier. It's bubbly. What did you do? What changed? So it's been an interesting experience of evidence coming back in ways that are unexpected.
Would it be fair to say that the orbs themselves exist in almost a hive mentality?
Do they play together and work together? Without a doubt. There's a connection to all the orbs that are out there. Hive mentality, possibly. I don't know that I've thought about it that way before.
You could say a shared mind or a... A group mind.
Yeah, which is what I would call a hive mentality. You know, the bees have it, and the ants have it, and the Borg have it. oh, no, it's Borg technology.
Well, you could call it a social memory complex. That sounds less frightening.
You have a little bit of a Picard look going to you. So, I mean, you know, there was this, I was like.
Oh, I try for that.
Yes, I was going to say, there's a little, you know, I was going to wait for the shields up or something to happen.
We have different people have different experiences. You can have no experience with anything metaphysical and no awareness of what this is, and you can come and sit and have a session. There will be a beneficial effect, although you might not be aware of what that is. People who channel and who play with energy frequently often report that they'll find, as they get comfortable in the Stargate, a lead orb, and that they're in communication with that orb, and that they'll ask for what it is that they need, and that that orb will direct the other orbs, which is interesting. I personally do not have that experience. They seem to work differently with different people depending on what their understanding and what their background is.
Well, if you have anything that is an intelligent awareness, intelligent awarenesses treat each experience as an individual experience and an interaction.
Yeah, and our understanding is that each person receives what it is that they need in that moment. Often it's not what they think they need, but it helps to move them forward.
Yeah, and I've played with lots of technology through the years. I mean, I've been out, you know, playing in the New Age spiritual community since the late 70s. We talked very briefly, but, you know, and so I have seen a plethora of different things come in. Some stay, some go out. I'm never a big believer of anything that's supposed to do all your work for you, because I think everything is to assist you to do your work. As soon as somebody tells me, oh, yeah, well, this is going to make, you know, you're going to have a fabulous life after this because it's going to take away all your everything and you have to do nothing, I go, scam! So, but if something is giving you perspective, maybe giving you a new tool.
Training wheels. They're all training wheels helping us remember who we are.
Yeah. So that's good. Now, what, you know, and, you know, we had talked before the show that Elmer, when he gets off it and I'm on it, he's going to talk to you a little bit more about kind of where you came as people into this. But now you've been doing this for
six years.
And you've been involved in that process at that length of time as well?
Two and a half.
2.5. So where did, so how did you come into to this?
How did I end up being the crazy crystal ball lady?
I'm doing him first right now. How did you come into this? Which orb are you?
Oh, well, let's see. I came into the orbit here.
Good. I like that.
It was August of 2015. I was at the contact in the desert where I was going as a relatively sane person, minding my own business, and going to hear my house guest, Stephen Bassett, talk about exopolitics. He is probably the only Washington, D.C. registered lobbyist who deals in that department, off-world diplomacy. So I was there to support Stephen, and I met Jacqui Neulinger. And essentially, she was the first person I saw at contact in the desert, Joshua Tree, California. And I sat down at her booth for a 5-day conference, and I spent 5 days in the booth. And I wanted to know more about the technologies and about the woman, and have learned quite a bit in 2.5 years.
So you were immediately attracted to her orbs.
You said that.
Dr. Kevin.
Okay, so... Of course they did. They would have taken my temperature had I let that one go by. Please. Okay. So I want to keep moving with the technology here a bit again, because I want Elmer to do more of like the personal history of what came together. So now we have something that all I can say makes me, I keep looking at it and think, oh, Twilight Zone. So what is the Twilight Zone type of structure that I can already build the episode in my mind? You're at a country fair in Iowa. You have this strange thing with lights.
And here it
the
is.
Kid's supposed to be throwing the thing, and then he gets this glazed look on his face, and he turns around and starts marching, and all the people start marching.
So we've never had that happen, actually, which I'm somewhat thrilled about. These
only somewhat.
Imagine, if you will.
These tools open a field of light and information, and they open a portal. This was the first session-based tool, and we've got over 40 of them out in North America. So in 6 years, we have shared and spread them.
Okay, so you've gotten 40 of the Merkaba orb.
Correct, the Stargate. This is the next evolution, and what's lovely about this tool, it is profound, it is extraordinary, a little bit different energy. It doesn't require a whole room. It can hang on a wall. This is the portable version. It's about 2 foot in diameter. They do come up to 5 feet in diameter with multiple layers. And what you're looking at there is a series of disks, hundreds of layers, again, of sacred and channel geometry, codes, and algorithms. The orbs that are mounted onto that disk are stainless steel orbs. They've also been charged in the trainer. And we've got light acceleration moving. There's copper wiring and grid work moving. And they are energetically connected to the wands that Elmer's holding. Okay.
We call them the Wi-Fi wands.
The Wi-Fi.
The Wi-Fi wands. Wi-Fi. Or the Wi-Fi wands, if you're in Europe.
The Wi-Fi wands?
The Wi-Fi, as they call it, Wi-Fi.
Wi-Fi.
When I started traveling with this, I do also teach holistic healthcare practitioners how to build an integrative practice. I travel in that group, and we started doing sessions with people who were practitioners themselves. And what the experience was across the board is that old unresolved issues would come up for these folks. Back pain from, they would identify it as maybe from an accident when they were a child or a young adult, that they kind of thought had been resolved, but not completely. And they would find that with the interaction with the Evo, it would start to resolve for them. Physical, mental, emotional, spiritual as well. So again, an opportunity to work through issues and do the work, maybe now at a different level of consciousness than when they first had experienced what it was that they'd experienced. You may have noticed when Elmer started doing a session, I asked him to begin by looking into the Evo and asking for what it was that he wanted. There's a profound observation and experience of people who use this, that when you ask to play something in your field, within this field of light and information, this field of energy, often people find that as they move forward, they do find that showing up for them in their field. So it's both of the tools open a portal.
Interesting.
Yeah.
And of course, because in the last 10 days, I have I've had repeated opportunities to have to redraw and sketch everything on the expo this weekend. Mm-hmm. And knowing that the space that you guys are going to be in, that little back by the, I can see exactly where the Evo goes. It would be the perfect place for it.
Yep.
Now, so you're going to have this set up at the expo. People are going to come and they can do sessions. And that's all expo stuff. You come to the expo, that's where you get the deal. You know, we don't sell, promote anything here. Mm-hmm. We are public access. But they can come and they can experience that there. Now, you have something else, because we've got about three to four more minutes before mm-hmm. Elmer's going to be cooked. Now, there's another technology you're also going to be offering, which we do not have on the stage.
We have several things. So we'll have these tools to experience at the expo. We'll also have smaller versions people can take with them. We also have two extraordinary wellness products. So these tools help support growth, wellness, health, and spiritual well-being, physical well-being. And we have some other tools that support that as well. The first one is a device called an amp coil, rather extraordinary. It's actually a Tesla coil that has been utilized as a pulsed electric magnetic field generator. And what this tool does is it incorporates biofeedback. There's a voice analysis biofeedback. It will report back what it is at this moment that is of issue for you. It will fold those items into the session you're about to do, and then it will take a frequencies of those items and turn those frequencies into sound, deliver that sound into an amplifier that then comes through the coil, this Tesla coil, as a pulsed electromagnetic field.
Interesting.
Yes, it is quite extraordinary. It's a newer technology for me that I've gotten involved with. They're having some really profound results with people who've been struggling with chronic autoimmune issues, Lyme disease, and preparing, another group is coming in to prepare to start doing some research studies and really start to look at the results. So we'll be offering that, talking about it, explaining it, people can have the chance to experience it. And we'll also have spice mixers, which is an extraordinary product we've been working with, developed by Vaughn over the last 6 months or so.
Okay.
Also that supports natural way to support wellness.
So I know, because we're going to have to stay on timing with all this, and when Elmer gets off, we're going to have to do that thing. So give me a... So the amp coil completely fascinates me. Love the Tesla stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Been a big fan for a long time. Spice mixers. Give me the 90-second elevator pitch, so to speak, on it. Like, what are they?
Well, starting from the first floor, literally, it is soil-based technology of going back to what the soil provides.
Okay.
Essentially, the borates and the silicates that used to be in our soil before they've been bleached out and used to be in our food chain, where you could call them the antidotes to modern exposure to all sorts of things that we just have no knowledge of what we're dealing with, what exactly are in the GMOs, what is in our atmosphere. A lot of people talk about chemtrails or bioengineering, weather modification. We don't know residual effects of vaccines or antibiotics, other medications. The intention is to go back to soil-based technology, include the borates, the silicates, and highly sourced organic spices, and let the body deal on a level playing surface with autoimmune conditions, Lyme disease, fibromyalgia, chronic fatigue syndrome, irritable bowel syndrome.
It's interesting because I've done both I haven't done any TV shows on it, but I've done a number of radio shows and spoke oftentimes on how there is 50% less nutrients in the soil now than there was 30 years ago.
Yeah.
And so when you have less nutrients and you have a soil that has been basically raped and pillaged, misused, that you can't expect that your food is going to supply the same thing that it should. So I'm getting that the time-wise, he should be getting ready to... Are you coming back to us, Elmer?
Does this repeat?
It shouldn't.
It shouldn't. So we're going to move Elmer off.
Yeah, you're good. You got maybe another 20 seconds.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's fascinating. We found at the booth, we'll give samples, and we have samples that we'll have this weekend.
I'll be over.
What's amazing to us is we've had some incredible testimonials. There'll be a woman who drinks it, walks away, comes back, and says, I've had rheumatoid arthritis.
Hold on to the front of the chair. Pull yourself up.
Yeah.
Well done.
And suddenly I can close my hands. So it's what you're saying.
Yeah.
There's a piece that's missing that the body recognizes, and for some people,
yeah.
Magic.
Completely get that. You know, I've worked as a medical intuitive for years, done a lot of work with protocols and different things. So you're going to talk more about your experience while I'm in the chair a little bit and then pick up the interview process of kind of what they're offering and where they came about with this stuff. But before I go into the chair,
what was your experience? Have you still been Mike? Mm-hmm. Good.
Yes.
What was that?
Very
relaxing. Actually, my arms started to go numb towards the end. But yeah, it was really relaxing. I like the soundtrack. It's very nice.
Also coded energetically.
Yeah. I noticed a lot with when I experience things like this. I don't end up necessarily have a conscious awareness of what's going on. A lot of times I take in information or I take in things I want to change, and then my subconscious takes over, and I don't have to worry about it, and it kind of things shift and change. And so I expect that's something I'll feel over the next few days as, you know, the energy from this.
I really appreciate that explanation, actually, because I think that that's true for many people, but they're not aware of it. So it's wonderful that you have an awareness that that's how your being processes this kind of information field that offers opportunity. That's fabulous. Thank you.
Okay, well, we're going to hook me up, and Elmer's going to take it over. I'm going to walk my little purple socks over there.
Elmer, I noticed that you had rapid eye movement while you were in there. Were you also conscious?
I was, and I have ADHD, so a lot of times my mind, you know, for me to meditate is hard, so I was trying to calm myself down and try not to, like, let my mind wander and stuff. So some of that might have been from that, trying to, and also I think at one point I almost did fall asleep.
A lot of people fall asleep, I do. We notice that expectations can be counterproductive with any of these technologies. Did you find anything got in your way? Something you were imagining you were going to experience?
My mind started to go there. I was just kind of like, okay, am I supposed to feel something physically? And then I just had to stop myself and be like, just open up, just trying to calm my mind, open up to the, you know, whatever is going to happen, open up to the energy. You know, you had mentioned to think of something that you want, and my just thought was just, I want to be the best that I can be, you know, be the best person I'm here to be and what I'm here to do. So just kind of be open to whatever that looks like.
Yes, we find that willingness, permission, giving yourself permission to be more of who you are naturally is key.
And allowing.
Yeah.
The allowing.
A lot of people have issues with that.
Yeah. We want to control.
Yep.
And we think that we should be able to control. And it's so challenging for us to remember that control is an illusion. Yeah.
Yeah, very much so.
Yeah.
Although Dr. Kevin looks like he's already surrendered to the Costco magic chair.
Yes. He's quick and easy when it comes to that kind of stuff. And now that we can't talk, you know, he can't hear us, we can talk about him.
Okay.
So. Okay.
So tell me, what is your background?
Where's my background? Varied, significantly varied. I started out with a very keen interest in science and all things measurable. Moved forward into a little bit of an artistic, ended up owning a film production company for many years outside the Philadelphia area. And found myself in an experience with a family that was in trauma. We had a series of unfortunate events and some significant trauma. And as we worked through the healing process of that trauma, what I found was that these technologies, these devices, these things I couldn't explain would appear. Somebody would know somebody
right.
who could help. And they would offer that, and I was incredibly resistant. I was protective of my children. It was things I could not...
Wasn't scientific.
I couldn't explain any cause of action. And I didn't want anyone to be more hurt. But over time, things that seemed the most mundane, I started to permit. And what I found was that there were things that I could not explain that were able to assist recovery and repair and healing in a way that was so unexpected to me. So I found myself slowly moving into a willingness to accept what I could not explain and what I could not understand. And I would have very positive feedback from the healthcare professionals that were working with my children, from other people that were involved. And I just moved further and further into it. And I remained pragmatic. So
kind of like a scientific mind, if you needed to experience it.
Correct. So I'm using, you know, I started letting other people start to work with my children. Then I started owning some of these devices, using them, and I couldn't explain how they could do what they could do. So I actually got involved in doing some clinical research around alternative medical devices to try and establish that, in fact, are they doing this? Is it placebo? What is it? How are they doing what they're doing? And that's what I was doing when I came in contact with this technology, which is the least likely technology for me to have ended up championing and working with, as I have for the past 6 years.
And Vaughn, what about you?
Well, I have a homeopathic and naturopathy background along with a career in building. But about 15 years ago, I am supposing that I contracted Lyme. And it was a grinding spiral down from there. So I went from running 5 marathons to not being able to run a 5K and then not being able to walk around the block. Cognitive impairment, physical pain, lack of mobility.
Right.
It got to the point where a year ago I could no longer work.
Wow.
Started investigating with Jacqui's support spice mixtures, the missing ingredients. Why are so many of us inflamed? Why do we have such intestinal dysbiosis or brain fog or fatigue or whatever it might be, migraines? What is the missing element? Why did people in my parents' and grandparents' generation not have these diseases, including autoimmune diseases?
Right.
In looking to see what is no longer in our food chain, but what originally was in the soil base, and experimenting with trying to put that into easy to use mixtures that can be taken as a supplement daily, I started getting better. Jacqui assured me that no one else would ever take these compounds because they tasted horrid, and she was right, so we've been working on that. We came up with something, current generations, that we feel are pretty tasty. People actually enjoy.
Is that something you're going to have at the expo?
Oh, yes. And we're going to be giving out free samples of hot spice mixer beverage boosters.
Oh, nice. I'll have to definitely come try one. So which one of you got introduced to the machine first?
Oh, this is... this technology reached out and called me from a place I can't describe. So I was doing clinical research and went to bed one night and had a dream. And in my dream, I'm sitting at a big round table with people from one of the technologies I'd been familiar with, and sitting next to a man who I don't know, a European man. And in the dream, he says to me, I'm going to come and see you in 2 months, and I'll keep coming back and we'll see what happens. And it was one of those dreams you wake up and it's just so real. I called a friend, I said, I had this strange dream, and you know, it started to diminish. And about 3 weeks later, I was invited to Budapest to lecture. And they flew me over to Budapest, big conference. And they take us all out one night to an event in the city, beautiful city, if you ever get a chance to visit. And got back on the bus to go back to the hotel. And the bus driver stops me. He says, I think this bus is full. And I'm standing at the front of the bus, and someone in the back says, no, no, there's one seat here. And I walk back to that empty seat, and I sit down, and I look up, and the man from the dream is introducing himself to me.
Wow.
And it was this extraordinary moment of other awareness that something was unfolding beyond my understanding.
Right.
We talked. You know, I thought, this is absurd. This is strange. We exchanged information. And we went our separate ways. He was from the Netherlands. And he started to contact me, and he wanted to come to America to visit. He was going to bring his girls. You know, I said, I'm traveling. Here's kind of when I'm here. Here's when I'm not. And he sent me a date and asked me to meet him in Manhattan. And that date was 2 months to the day from the day on the bus. And we're standing in Manhattan, and he has brought me a gift, and he gives me the first of these orbs. He says, my friend makes it. It's filled with the frequency of love. And you do research. If anyone might know what it is, we think maybe you would know what it is. And I thanked him, and I thought, I don't do crystal balls. I can't plug it into a wall. I can't measure it. It's a crystal ball. I mean,
right.
It's beautiful, but don't do this. And was staying with a girlfriend in Manhattan and went back to her place, and she held it and she said, oh my, this is extraordinary. I feel relaxed, I feel connected, I feel beautiful. So I'm a researcher, and what I did was I started to hand it to people. And what I found is that nobody wanted to give it back. And my friends were creating a schedule. They would hold it for 2 days, they would drive it to someone else's house, they would keep it for 2 days, they wanted more of them, and I'm just watching this unfold and thinking, this is rather extraordinary. So I started to play with it myself, and I did find that it felt like there was, that it opened a stream of energy, a knowing of self, in a way that I hadn't experienced. And you know, a little bit of time passed by, and I sent an email. They'd asked what I thought, and I said, you know, according to my basic understanding of quantum mechanics, I think maybe you've done this, this, and this. And I get back a very excited email from a third person in the Netherlands who says, yes, it's this, this, and this, and it's also this, and who are you? And so this is who I am, and here's how I got this thing, and he sends me a box with more of them. And again, everybody wants them, they want to keep them. And then I had an experience driving into Manhattan. I was teaching a workshop, and I had that size orb. It was the first one in my car. And I came over a hill, icy morning, tractor trailer is jackknifing and overturning, and I get over to the side of the road, and I stop my vehicle, and I'm rear-ended by a truck. And look around, you know, there's five other cars. It's a bad scene. They close the roadway for about 3 hours. And state troopers take our information. The ambulances come to the scene. I'm seeing nobody's leaving in an ambulance. Everybody's okay. They deal with the roadway. We're getting ready to leave, and the state trooper asks me to exit my vehicle, and he says to me, can you tell us what happened? And I said, well, you know, you have my statement. He's got the guy with the truck driver behind me, and we said, we've both told you what happened, and he said, it's not possible. He said, I've got to tow the truck, and you've got a dent. Something else, we both said, this is what happened. We drove away, and I drove the car for quite a while, 6-7 weeks, and I brought it in to be repaired. And the first thing that happened was that I went to get into the rental car, and the woman who owns the repair company came out, and she said, I'm sorry, your car is not drivable. And I said, I've been driving the car for 6 weeks. Of course the car is drivable. Right. You know, it was ridiculous. And the next day I got a call from the adjuster, and he said to me, I've never seen anything quite like this. He said, your vehicle is designed to crush, to crumble, crush zone. He said, but somehow the energy undulated through the vehicle from the impact, and there are ripples everywhere. He told me there was over $7,000 of damage to the vehicle. And they repaired it, and I was aware that something was going on that was not what it appeared to be. When I finally spoke to John about it, he said that they get reports like that all over the world of people who find themselves in a moment, an accident, a potential unfolding of some sort, and it's almost as though there's a sidestep or an ironing out of that wrinkle that allows your path to continue in a way that it might not have. So in my world, what happened was that my two semi-adult kids at that point were not allowed to drive their cars without a little pendant hanging from the rearview mirror.
Nice.
And we do have now technology for that.
Are you going to have the pendants at the expo?
Yeah.
Because that would be something I might be interested in.
Yeah.
I want to go back to something you mentioned earlier. So a year ago, you couldn't work anymore. So are you able to run a marathon now?
Yes.
In New York City on New Year's Eve, I ran the 4 mile around Central Park on excuse me, the stroke of midnight. So the fireworks go off in New York City. 5,000 of us run around the Central Park, and that was my defining moment of, yes, I'm back on the right track.
Mm-hmm. Great. It's good to hear.
So,
and able to move these, I mean, you know, you've got 700 pounds of wood and crystal. Vaughn is able to literally, you know, function in that way and move everything, and it's fabulous.
So yeah, I have a cold, but I can move.
Right. So these are manufactured in another country?
Czech Republic.
Okay. And so how did you two meet?
We've talked about that, actually.
Oh, how did we meet?
Yeah.
At an expo,
it was,
of course.
Of course.
It was odd. But Jacqui gave me a present. She gave me a little cobalt-colored orb, smaller than the smaller ones here. And it was in a box. It was just a token. And I had the funniest feeling, you know, we were going to go to Giant Rock in Joshua Tree, which is a sacred, a traditionally sacred freestanding boulder in the desert.
Right.
I went to pull the cobalt orb out of the box, and I felt myself moving. Like traveling through, beginning to travel through space and time. I shoved it back in the box. It's like, no, I have a date. I don't know where I'm going here. So I put it back, like put the genie back in the bottle.
Right.
You know, and we went to Giant Rock later that night. But it's been that type of experience, really.
Nice. So I know you did some of this with Dr. Kevin, but these two can be used independently.
Yes.
And
what we've been finding that people experience are twofold. Often older injuries or unresolved emotional traumas resurface in awareness as a way to move through. What people sometimes experience is an injury from 20 years ago, and they can feel it moving through their body and almost restructuring and repairing in a way that it hadn't. The other thing that we find is an ability to place into your field what it is that you desire or you want to work on. So when I ask, what is it that you want to speak that and to request it, you're actually in creation of your experience moving forward to incorporate whatever it is that needs to come in order for you to move through that and have the opportunity to have it manifest in your experience.
Yes, like Wayne Dyer says in his book, intention, the only true force in the universe. Like human intentionality or will, there's something remarkable about choice. And these energy field systems allow an elevated frequency field where you can make superior choices.
Right. So how do you feel?
See, I knew it was really Jean-Luc Picard. Now he's talking about Will. That's Will Riker, right? Oh, sorry. It was a very interesting experience. You know, obviously I'm into the hype of 36 hours before this big thing kicks off. So my first experience with it was basically it kind of just being like, let go. Just like it, I could feel it like. And so the first few minutes was it kind of like, okay, get all the thoughts out of your mind, let them all go. Heard a little Idina Menzel singing. Everything you need to learn about life, you can learn through a Broadway musical.
Absolutely.
Just so you know. I have a class I teach called that.
I'm a New Yorker.
So there you go. But then I kind of like floated into a different level of, I don't know how much the camera or you guys caught me, but there was definite movement. It needed to start behind my neck. There was something jammed there. And it was like, okay, so for what I had asked, you know, the Evo. Again, I think there's a little Twilight Zone going on here. So for what I asked for the Evo, it was like, okay, there's something jammed there that needs to be released. So there's something there that's an interference in the... So my awareness of the interaction was fairly high. I didn't drift off really in any of it. I was like, okay, do this. Okay, yeah, that's done. Okay, you get some energy clogged stuck here. Okay, move this here. I know at one point it was like, I was actually had it like this, and I was like, okay, I can, that there was a, you know, so it was kind of like guiding me around of where did it want to go. So it was, you've put out this is what you want. I'm going to show you where you're most blocked into getting it at this point or where you may have things that are interfering. And so we're going to kind of guide you through the process of moving it and doing it. Not surprising for me, I tend to be very interactive.
Yes, intelligent technology. And as I'm listening to you, I'm aware of that. So for you, it's not surprising that you would hear and know where to move and what to do. What is surprising to me is when we get folks at not even a metaphysical or spiritual expo, but you know, the gem show or you know the average human being who walks by, well, what is that? You know, and they'll go and they'll sit down and they'll look at us and they'll say, well, I can feel the energy in my hand, or they'll start moving, doing what you did and saying, well, I don't know why, but I know I'm supposed to place it here or here or here, and this will come up for them to talk to us afterwards. It's always incredible to see
You know, Dr. Kevin, there's nothing really outside yourself in the magic Costco chair. There's only one occupant there at a time, and we believe that it's just a deeper knowing of your own self that is allowed to emerge and interact with your regular consciousness. But it's nothing outside of you.
Yeah. Well, and you know, and sometimes then it's very interesting because as someone who's got a lot of energy work and even massage and other types of things like this, you know, if somebody is working either even physically and or energetically on me doing something, I'll be like, oh, okay, like if they say there's a knot here or there's a block here, I immediately go, whoosh, okay. And they're like, what did you just do? Well, you pointed it out and it was flying beneath my radar, so I'm gonna direct that energy in there. Your amp coil still fascinates me, so I'm going to at some point sneak over to your booth when I can get some time and just kind of go, show me this thing.
Oh, it is remarkable. It really is.
Yeah.
So
lots of fun tech.
But this was great. Definitely one of the things I do want to say is we're looking at a Dr. Kevin that's been probably doing 4 or less hours of sleep a night for the last 2, 3, 4 nights as I'm ramping up. And I do come out of this with like, oh, my energy level feels solid and flowing.
You're more present. We ran into you earlier, and you were really getting ready for this thing, and there's so much going on, and this has happened. And now you are
solid.
Present. And the way that I most frequently explain to people how this technology works, whether it's the small ones or the session-based systems, it increases the coherence of the human biofield. So after this, what I would expect is that you are much more Dr. Kevin and much less affected by everything that's pressing around you, which I would say is pretty much what you look like at the moment.
Mm. Yeah, it's very interesting. And one of the things that I would invite our viewers to be aware of is that we are in very scattered times.
Yes.
And we are getting hit by a lot of things on a lot of different levels, a lot of fears, a lot of uncertainties, a lot of unpredictabilities. And I was just saying to a client of mine the other day, when we were doing some shielding work and stuff like that, I'm like, you're taking your energetic body out into a maelstrom of, you know, almost nuclear level emotions and activities.
Yeah, people can really feel it.
Yep. And so I would definitely encourage people that are going to come to the Web of Light Expo this weekend at the Courtyard Marriott, 10 to 6 on Saturday and 11 to 5 on Sunday. That if you're feeling scattered, if you're feeling like there's bits and pieces of you that are floating out there, that this, I mean, I don't know if you felt more solid when, I know you said you felt more relaxed. But
I'm definitely more centered.
Yeah, and I can see it in you. Mm-hmm. I can feel it in me, but I can see it in you. Mm-hmm. Is that that? That if the world has been getting the better side of the race, this might be a perfect stop for you.
Yeah, and for people who are local, it's a wonderful opportunity because while we do have 40 of them out across North America, there are none in New England. So it's an incredible opportunity. The closest one to here is Northern New Jersey.
Okay.
So. And you should add that we're always looking to find homes for the Stargate and the Evos.
Yeah, and often gatekeepers will know.
Okay, good. We are wrapping up the show. But again, Jacqui and Vaughn will be at the Expo all weekend long. You are speaking on Lyme disease.
Mm-hmm. I am.
And you are speaking on
Applied Cymatics.
Yes.
So sound and biogeometric creation, both with the amp coil and a little bit with this technology as well.
Okay. Well, I want to thank you both for coming.
Thank you so much. A pleasure.
And as we sign out of this Web of Light special, just before we go into the expo this weekend, the world is happening to you. Are you going to ride the wave or be drowned by it? There are some tools and skills and opportunities being offered. Are you going to grab them or are you just going to sit around and complain? Namaste.